has also been an even longer time since I've done anything in regards to comic books, so I wasn't really quite sure what to do in that regard with the comics, because I've really stopped collecting for a lot of different reasons. I don't really have time anymore, and also because of money. Not that I couldn't still continue to buy a couple of them, but it's just kind of fizzled out. So, but I'm still a big Walking Dead fan, and I thought, well, of all the comics to pick, why not start reviewing the trade paperbacks? So we are going to take a look at The Walking Dead, Volume 1, Days Gone By, which collects issues, I believe, 1 through 6 or 1 through 5, 1 through 6. So each trade paperback, or TBP as they call them, collects or contains 6 issues of the comic book. And as far as the beer review, whether you're drinking along with me or not, beer, water, soda, whatever it might be, I am going to review the Ale Works Coffee House Stout. And I'm assuming it's got a nice, hoping it has a nice coffee aroma and flavor. And along with that, I thought I would also partake in some candy stout, and chocolate or anything like that usually goes well. So I'm gonna munch on some of those, but first we're gonna do the beer review, and then we'll check out the comic book. So for those of you who've never seen these videos before, this is basically what I do. Again, for those of you who have been waiting for a more traditional ASMR video of mine, and who have been putting up with some of my more artistic stuff, again, I want to say thank you. I like to mix things up, and that's just how I've always been. I try to enjoy this life to its fullest as much as possible, especially when it comes to being creative. But enough about that. So now, before we begin, we gotta do our aerobics. I like to take about 10 seconds out of the day to do my exercises. So I have here this can opener, also a corkscrew. So we're gonna do 10 reps and raise our arms up. If you don't have this kind of can opener, that's okay. You can just use your arms or your eyebrows, your eyelids, anything. You can even nod your head 10 times. That's great. Burns a lot of calories. All right, here we go. 1. craft beers. We'll give a little explanation maybe about the way they brewed the beer or the company. So let's just open this up. Subtle. would say, strong aroma of coffee or taste of coffee. But the aroma and the taste are pretty much on par for being somewhat subtle and light, unlike the chocolate stout and the blueberry stout. They had a very strong aroma. The coffee, I mean the chocolate, had a strong chocolate taste. You couldn't taste the blueberry at all, but this has a light coffee aroma, a light and a very balanced aroma and taste. So I would give this, for being a coffee stout, I would give it a 3. It's and for being a stout, I give it a 3. It's nothing stand out really. It's a good, it's a good stout. I'll give it 3.5, but it's nothing. I would have it again, but I really wouldn't go out of my way to go for it just because it's a coffee stout. Some of you have wanted me to drag things across the mic, so I'm gonna try to do this. And you let me know what you think, because if you like me dragging objects across the mic, I will do a full video of that. I just don't know how many of you like that. The other thing is, no matter what you drag across the mic, it's always going to have that sound. Except you'll have that scratchy sound, I would say, mixed with the sound of whatever the object is. But you're not going to have a different mic scratching sound. It's always going to be something. That same dragging sound is always going to be the same. So said, you just let me know if you like that. Okay, I don't want to get my fingers all chocolatey as I read the comic book. So far in my career, I'm the guy that created Battle Pope. guys realize what a stretch this is for me. It's really not that hard to believe when you realize that I'm delving into subject matter that is so utterly serious and dramatic. Zombies. To me, the best zombie movies aren't the splatterfests of gore and violence, I agree, with goofy characters and tongue-in-cheek antics, agree. Good zombie movies show us how messed up we are. They make us question our station in society and our society's station in the world. They show us gore and violence and all that cool stuff too. But there's always an undercurrent of social commentary and thoughtfulness. Give me Dawn of the Dead over Return of the Living Dead any day. Agreed. To me, zombie movies are thought-provoking, dramatic fiction on par with any Oscar-worthy garbage that's rolled out year after year. Movies that make you question the fabric of our very society are what I like. So do I. And in good zombie movies, you get that by the truckload. With The Walking Dead, I want to explore how people deal with extreme situations and how these events change them. I'm in this for the long haul, and he is, because there's like 100 and something issues right now, going back to, 95 or something. Not that far back. 12 into 100 is 10, 9 years, so 2004, something like that. 95. You guys are going to get to see Rick change and mature to the point that when you look back on this book, you won't even recognize him. I hope you guys are looking forward to a sprawling epic, because that's the idea with this one. Everything in this book is an attempt at showing the natural progression of events that I think would occur in these situations. This is a very character-driven endeavor. How these characters get there is much more important than them getting there. I hope to show you reflections of your friends, your neighbors, your families, and yourselves, and what their reactions are to extreme situations on this book. So, if anything scares you, great. But this is not a horror book. And by that, I do not mean we think we're above that genre. Far from it. We are just setting out on a different path here. This book is more about watching Rick survive than it is about watching zombies pop around the corner and scare you. I hope that's what you guys are into. All story commentary aside, at the very least, even if you hate the thing, you've got to admit, it at least looks good. So he goes on a little bit about Toni Moore's artwork. And then he finishes up with, for me, the worst part of every zombie movie is the end. I always want to know what happens next. Even when all the characters die at the end, I just want it to keep going. More often than not, zombie movies feel like a slice of a person's life, shown until whoever is in charge of the movie gets bored. So we get to know the character, they have an adventure, and then, boom, as soon as things start getting good, those pesky credits start rolling. The idea behind The Walking Dead is to stay with the character, in this case, Rick Grimes, for as long as is humanly possible. I want The Walking Dead to be a chronicle of years of Rick's life. We will never wonder what happens to Rick next. We will see it. The Walking Dead will be the zombie movie that never ends. Well, not for a long time at least. Robert Kirkman. So the book starts out with Rick and Shane having a standoff with some crazy local guy. They're kind of pinned down behind their car. He's got a shotgun. He's shooting at them. So Rick says to Shane he's going to get up and go across the road to a ditch, try to surround him, and that's when he gets shot. And then the next thing we see, he wakes up in a coma, from his coma, in a hospital room. He gets up out of the bed, and he falls out. He cries out, "Nurse." He goes walking through the hall, and everything's empty. He goes into the elevator. The elevator door opens up, and a zombie falls out. I mean, a walker falls out. He screams out, "Help!" He keeps walking through the hospital, and he opens up the hospital cafeteria, and there's a whole bunch of zombies in here. And he finally tries to make his way out of the hospital, and he gets out the door and into the, I guess, the parking garage area of the hospital, and he takes off his belt, and he closes the belts, the hospital doors closed, and you can see him walking away from the hospital, and he ends up coming across, if you remember in the first season, the zombie that was in the grass. It just had its upper torso. That's the zombie right there. So he comes across that zombie, and he starts to cry, and everything starts to hit him. And he comes across a bike, and he just kind of kneels down on the ground, and he's just like, you know, he can't, you know, what's going on? He wakes up out of a coma, and there's just, what the heck's going on, you know? So he ends up going back to his house up top there. There's his neighborhood. It's all kind of in shambles. He goes into the house, and there's nothing in there. Nobody's in there. Nothing's left, really. And then we see a shot of a shovel. Someone holding a shovel, and he gets hit on the head with a shovel. And that's when he comes across Morgan and his son, Dwayne. And they end up kind of explaining to him what happened. But then Rick shows him a key to the police station, so they end up driving in Morgan's hatchback. They go to the police station, and they find an arsenal of guns in one of, I guess, the store, I guess you would say. And that's where Rick ends up putting on his uniform for the first time right here. And that's basically the encounter with Morgan. He gives Morgan a key to a police car right here in the scene. Basically, they walk out, I guess, behind the police station, and he gives Morgan a key, and he basically says, you know, take care of the car. And he's like, hey, thanks a lot, Rick, you know, this helps a lot. And I'm not sure, I don't remember if they ever see Morgan again in the later trade paperbacks. Someone will have to keep me straight on that, but that's basically it. There's no scene with him in the TV show. It's a little different. We have Morgan shooting the zombies out of the house and things like that. That doesn't really happen here. It's really just a few panels. And nothing about his wife being a zombie, at least in here. So Rick ends up taking the car. He goes back to the zombie torso, and you know, the zombie lady, that's half a torso, whatever you call it, and shoots in the head, and he kind of wipes away a tear. So, you know, this, he's just trying to process everything. You know, I can only imagine what it'd be like, because they don't really talk about zombies in these books. There's no zombie lore. It's not like a story about us and how we know about zombie culture and things like that. There's just, it's just dead people walking around. Let's see, how about a Hershey kiss? To a gas station, but there's no gas left, and he's cursing. He runs out of gas, so he takes his duffel bag, police duffel bag, with a couple of guns in there, and he's walking down the road, and he comes to a house that's, there's like some wooden fence along the side of the road, and there's a house back in the distance, so he goes into the house, and he comes across this scene here, where the family pretty much with a father. There's a guy sitting in the chair back with the gun in his hand, and he shot the other people. It looks like a wife maybe and two kids, and they're all holding their Bibles. So he gets sick, he runs outside, he sees a barn, there's a horse in the barn, so he gets on the horse and takes the horse. On the TV show, he takes the horse into town, I think, and ends up getting into the tank. And that's what happens. He takes the horse into town, but there's no tank, and he basically gets surrounded here. You can see him. He gets surrounded by zombies. The horse bucks. He gets thrown off, and the zombies start tearing apart the horse. And see how good that artwork is. Great work. Of course, they switched artists after a few episodes. So he's freaking out. He's like, "You know what's wrong with you people?" And he starts shooting the zombies. And then finally, he meets Glenn for the first time. And Glenn kind of yanks him and takes him into the alley, and they go up the fire escape. So there's no, I think in the TV show, I forget how they meet. Oh yeah, it was Glenn on the radio. That's right. Into the tank or something like that. So they traverse. They jump across a rooftop onto another roof. They get down, and they end up behind the city, I guess, and going into the woods. And they go back, Glenn, you know, is talking to him, and finally Rick, before, you know, they're in the woods, and he kneels down, and he's like, "My wife, my son," he's crying and stuff, so, but they eventually end up at camp, and Rick's like, "Holy shit," and that's where, you know, he sees Lori and Carl. So they're happy to see him, and Shane's there, and Shane's like, "Good to see you too." And so then he ends up meeting everyone, and so there's Dale. He ends up there's Dale, and we have Carol and Sophia. This is Alan and his wife Donna, and they have two kids. was Shane, and there's Donna, and that's the whole group. Of course, he has the RV, and so he ends up getting back, you know, to having a little conversation with Lori in a tent. Or actually, they're sitting outside their tents, and Dale is up on the keeping watch. I think it's Dale, whoever. He wakes up the next morning. He meets up with. Shane, and I think they're talking about going hunting. He ends up bumping into Dale, and Dale's like, "You know, Shane, he's a good man, but he's not glad you're back. He had his eye on Lori for as long as I've known them." So right there, you know, Dale kind of knows what's going on, and that kind of plays into the TV show where Dale was always untrustworthy of Shane. I'm not sure how long or at what point that happened in the TV show, but so Rick and Shane, they go for they start to go hunting. Here is a Hershey Crackle. It's chocolate and crisped rice. And you can see the like the formation or whatever, the crispy rice. Say cheers. So if you got something to drink, ready on a count of three. 1, 2, 3. Cheers. Clink. And the reason I haven't done a beer review in a while is because I haven't had a beer. The last time I had a beer was about 2 weeks ago. I've had a beer, a couple beers after the last beer review. I just needed a break. That's how I roll, so to speak. I get into a creative mode, and then I get into a mode to do other things. It's just how it is. So then we have Carol and Donna. Down to the creek, and if you remember in the first couple episodes of the first season, I think it was all of them, they end up going down to the, doing the same thing, washing the laundry. And then here's Sophia and Carl, and talking about how Carl's like, "Is your daddy dead?" And she's like, "Yeah, but so was your daddy, and he came back." And Carl's like, "My daddy was just sick. He wasn't dead." And poor Sophia, she's like, "Oh, I miss my daddy." So there was no abusive husband to Carol, or at least that I know of. I don't remember if she ever says there was, but there's no abusive husband in this in the comic playing Carol's husband. So Rick and Shane, they go in the woods. They stumble upon a zombie eating a deer, and they're like, "Can we get the deer meat? Is it still gonna be good?" Meanwhile, the Lori, Donna, and Carol are washing laundry. They come back to camp, and there's a zombie that in the woods watching them as they go back to camp. So Alan is up watching. And he sees him coming out, And he's like, look out, there's a zombie behind you. Donna turns around and she's like, ah. And he's like, look out, he wants to shoot the zombie, but she's in the way. So Dale comes up on the zombie and uses an axe and chops off the zombie's head. And they see the zombie still going, with its head cut off. So, meanwhile, Shane and Rick are trying to figure out what to do with the zombie that's eating the deer in the woods. So they kill the zombie. And then they hear the gunshot back at camp, so they run back to camp. And Rick grabs Lori, and he's like, you're safe with me. And you can see while he's holding Lori, there's Shane, and he's not quite happy about that. So Shane's on lookout. Rick comes up to talk to Shane, and Rick's like, no, we shouldn't stay too close to the city. And Rick is like, no, we're staying here. And, he gets real busy. And Dale's like, can you keep it down? Some of us are trying to sleep, so we wake up the next day. And Rick and Glenn are heading back to the city to get more guns. Rick asks Jim if he knows if there's a gun store or anything. Time for some Reese peanut butter cup, my favorite peanut butter and chocolate. Whether it's chocolate or chocolate ice cream, just mix some peanut butter in with the chocolate ice cream. It's great. I try not to eat too much candy for the simple fact of it's candy. And what it does teeth and it's fattening, etc. But I got a sweet tooth. I have the biggest sweet tooth probably in the world. It's tough breaking that habit. But hey, you only live once, right? So, Rick and Glenn, they go back, and Rick takes Glenn to the zombie that was eating the deer that Rick and Shane found. And Rick chops off the hand, and he tells Glenn to spread the zombie blood all over him. And Glenn, is like, what? And he does, and he throws up twice. And Rick's like, I'm going to feel real stupid if we did this for nothing. So they head back into Atlanta, or into the city. I'm assuming it's Atlanta. And that's when they come across the tank. Right there. So you can see a TV show is a little bit different. So they're walking past all the zombies. The zombies don't notice them because of the zombie blood and all over them, pretty much. They get into a gun store. They come back out, and it starts to rain. And I think that's what happens in the TV show, too. So it starts to rain. They have a hole. They have a shopping cart full of guns and ammo that spills out. Zombies are coming after them. Rick almost gets bit, but the zombie only bit his coat. So they're fighting those off. So they make their way back. Rick's like, don't tell Lori about this. Meanwhile, Shane is trying to talk to Lori. He's got they're outside in the rain. He's trying to grab her hand, come back to camp. It's too cold to be out here. She's actually out there by herself, I guess, just thinking about everything that's happened. She's like, Shane, stop. You've got to stop. Rick is back now. He's like, but what about that night? And she's like, that night was a mistake. She says that right here, and there's Glenn's, Shane's expression. So then we have a couple scenes where it stops raining, and they make it back to camp. It stopped raining, but it's been a while, and we see Blam Blam, and Rick is teaching everyone how to shoot a gun, and there's Andrea shooting, and Donna is like, I'm nowhere near as good as Andrea, and Andrea's doing pretty good. So Rick is like, Carl, you ready to shoot? And Lori looks at him like she's pissed. But he's like, you know, this is what we gotta do. So they go out away from the camp to shoot off all the, you know, do the target practice so they don't attract a crowd. So I think in a TV show they were, if I'm not mistaken, they were doing target practice at Herschel's farm, wasn't it? I can't remember, but I thought that's where they did the target practice, but I thought they were on Herschel's farm. And they were shooting everything off of his fence. I can't remember. So, so Shane, Rick, and oh my god, I can't. The old man. Why can't I think of his name? They head back out. Dale. They go in the woods to get firewood. Now it's snowing. You can just see here a little bit of snow falling. And Shane's starting to get real pissed that Rick's back. And he just snaps and says something. And it's like Dale and Rick are just looking at him like, what are you talking about? So Shane walks back ahead of Rick and Dale. And Dale's like, that boy's got problems. So then they're all talking around the campfire at night while it's snowing, and we find out that Dale was a salesman for like 40 years. Then he retired, and they were on the road for 2 years when everything started happening. They left Florida. They were at a campsite, and his wife never left the campsite. We have Amy and Andrea. They're the sisters, and Amy was in college when everything happened. Andrea was driving her back to classes. Andrea was a clerk at a law firm. Glenn was a pizza boy. Alan was a manager, a shoe salesman. He ran a store in the mall. And Jim was a mechanic. So I think they're eating the deer they found in the woods. But they're sitting around the campfire, and Amy gets up. She says, gotta go pee. She goes back to the RV, and that's when Amy, if you can see that right there, a zombie comes. There's a couple zombies on each side of the RV. She sees this one. You can see this one's hand, and then you can see it just tears right into her neck. She falls down. She's gurgling on her own blood. So Shane and Rick and Dale, they get up, start shooting them. Everybody else is trying to run for cover, but no one else gets hurt. There's a lot of gunfire. Lori drops her gun. Carl comes and picks up his gun and shoots a zombie right in the head. Jim, he's got a gun too, and a zombie falls on Jim. Just like that. And Jim's taking out his frustrations. He's like, you killed my family. He's just killing the zombie. And basically Amy just dies out. And Dale is sitting next to Andrea, and she's like, oh, Dale. Then all of a sudden you see Blam, and Dale's like, and she's like, I can't let her come back like that. And basically Andrea had to kill her sister. And meanwhile, Jim stands up and he's just like, it's just a scratch. So they wrap him up. They end up burying. Gang Amy right there. There's Andrew. And Dale's like, you know, he's running a fever and all this. And he's like, tell everybody, you know, I you know, to kill me or whatever. You know, I can't go on. So Rick and Shane go out in the woods to go hunting with Carl. They find a rabbit, and Shane starts just ranting, going off. And he's like, we're not safe, and all this stuff. And he's like, think, Rick, you know, the army is going to drive through here any day, and all this will just go away. And he doesn't want to leave camp or anything. And there's Dale comforting Andrea, so you can see how close that they got. And finally, Jim is like, you know, just let me go. And you can see here that they leave him at a tree. Kind of like they did, I don't know, was it season one before they got to Herschel's farm or after? I don't know, I think it was before. And they left the guy, the tree, there on the road. But this was still at a camp. So, so that Rick and Shane get up the next day, go hunting. Carl's like, I want to come along. Rick's like, no. And it's like, why? Because Shane and I gotta talk. Then all of a sudden, Shane's like, what do we have to talk about? And Rick's like, what the hell do you think? And then Shane slugs Rick. They kind of get into a little bit, and everybody's watching. And Lori comes over to Rick's side, and she's looking at Shane's like, what the fuck is wrong with you? And he's like, I, and he's like, fuck this, and he walks off. And Rick's like, and he's like, Shane, wait. So he goes off into the woods. Carl goes running after him, and then you can see Shane loses it right there. He just starts going off. He's like, everything was so perfect until you came back. And then he pulls a gun on Rick. And then that's where Carl shoots Shane right through the neck. Right there, right in the sixth comic, Shane gets killed. Unlike in the TV show, they drug Shane's character out for a long time. And that's pretty cool. That's what I like about the show. It's very different. You don't know when the next character is going to go, and I'm glad that, you know, it's like that, because it's a lot different for most part. And Carl's like, it's not the same as killing the dead ones, Daddy. And at the end, the very end of the trade paperback, Rick's like, it never should be, son. It never should be. So that's the first six issues in the first trade paperback. I have 15 more to go through. I would like to do these, I don't want to say once a week, because every time I say once a week, it ends up being once a month. But, you know, there's just a lot of things I want to do. But I'm going to definitely continue this particular type of format and go over each book. And so with that finishes our beer. I hope you found that enjoyable. Let me know what you think about The Walking Dead. You might be able to find it at a library and be able to rent the trade paperbacks. Some libraries do that. Libraries, if you go to your local library, or there's certain websites that will even tell you, I think. I know I was talking with my brother who lives in San Francisco, and I went to his San Francisco library's website. I forget what library it was. and I was able to find The Walking Dead, I think. So, but yeah, it's a great comic book, just character driven. It's like, you know, in a zombie apocalypse world, things get a lot crazier. And I'm looking forward to, so I'll try to do this once a week. I'll try. Maybe we'll just, you know, I know some other people don't like comic books and they like to hear my beer reviews with me doing activity, but maybe we do this. I don't know. You know me. I'll mix it up. We'll see. All right. So that's really about it. I'm going to try to do another ASMR lounge next after this, but stay tuned for another beer review. Hope you relaxed, got a chance to unwind, maybe even fell asleep. And as always, thanks for watching. Thanks for your support. Much appreciated. It was good to see you again. And until next time, take care of yourself. And as always, tingle on. Bye-bye. Man, this was...